our farm would be hurt bad.
Roger Ruthrich grows corn, soybeans, and wheat on about 3,400 acres of land in Davis County.
It's a way of life. It's not always the easiest way of life. You learn to depend on the weather. You learn to depend on the markets. A lot of things you don't have control of.
The future of NAFTA being one of them.
It would be devastating the way we see it. A third of our corn is exported to Mexico. Our biggest importer of ethanol is Canada. It would have huge ramifications.
To Ruthrich, though, the risks are worth it. He says farming is a great way to raise a family.
Roger tells me he has four generations of farming right here in Davis County. He's hoping to make it five generations with his son.
I'm trying to bring a young son into farming. He's working into the farm with me. He's actually quit his job now, and he's going to come home, and we need some profitability to make this all work.
Oftentimes, Ruthrich says his corn is shipped to Eddyville to be made into ethanol, and then some of it goes to Keokuk. From there, it's shipped to wherever the market may be. According to the Iowa Corn Growers Association, the United States exported 13.89 million metric tons of corn to Mexico last year. That holds a value of $2.5 billion.
Trade agreements like this that are 25, 27 years old, there are places that they can be improved, can be updated, but agriculture has been such a beneficiary of this trade agreement over the past 20 years and has really, you know, made Mexico and Canada our largest customers for corn products and the meats, that we want to maintain those markets and continue to increase those markets.
Reporting in Bloomfield, Iowa, Beth Walden, KTVO News.